the ghost girl who's unaware she's dead. As a journalist, I covered the court case of the murder of a 19-year-old girl for our local tabloid newspaper. Since then, for many years, a female voice yelled my name repeatedly in my sleep, which would awaken me each early morning at precisely the same time at exactly 4 in the morning. I never had any wide awake direct contact with dead people or ghosts earlier in my life, but my life was about to change drastically. Please click like as it helps to grow the channel. You can subscribe so that you can be notified by further video clips on the paranormal life. I have included further video clips on ghostly encounters at the end of this video. I have also left my email below. If you want to share your own ghostly encounters, please do so. I did not know what was going on or who or what screamed my name over and over every night at 4. I at first shrugged it off as just a dream in my sleep state, although I also considered it as quite bizarre. I had no idea what was really going on. One late afternoon late in 2019, I arrived home and unaware I would have a paranormal encounter. I took a quick bite and gulped down a mug of coffee. I hid for a quick shower and threw myself on my stomach on the bed. I was dead tired of the day's work. I closed my eyes, trying to fall asleep when all of a sudden I heard the same female voice yelling my name very loud through the back of my head. My eyes flickered open. It is a ghost, I remember thinking. I jumped up, looked around. There was no one in the room. I live alone. I had locked all the doors in the apartment. I was all alone. I sat up straight on my bed, asking, "Who are you?" The response came instantaneously. The female voice uttered her name clearly in a high-pitched tone inside my one ear. Normally I would be unable to hear or see a ghost, but that day I clearly heard an out-of-body voice. I further said, "Who are you?" It was as if the ghost knew what I was going to say next. My question had hardly ended when I had the ghost say, "You got my photo. You would have most probably flew out of your house even at the dead of night." Quite the contrary, I was intrigued. The following day when I entered my apartment, I heard the same voice saying, "Hello." Then I heard loud weeping from the corner of the room. I said, "Why are you crying?" There was no response. Or maybe I was unable to hear what the ghost said next. I was puzzled about who the ghost was. It dawned upon me after about a week, I might have written a story on her murder. Her name was a clue regarding the identity of the dead ghost girl. I went through all the articles I had written for the daily newspaper I worked at in Cape Town, South Africa, since August 2008. I eventually found a story I had written in December 2010. She was stabbed to death in her neck by her ex-boyfriend in front of her family house near to where I lived. I made a photocopy of the article with a photograph of the deceased girl. She was 19 when she was murdered. After about a decade had gone by, the ghost appeared to be still 19. When I got home, I heard the familiar high-pitched voice once again saying, "Hello." I placed the copy of the story, with a photo of the ghost, I had written on my bed and asked the invisible entity, "Is this you?" The answer came immediately in my one ear, "Yes, yes. Yes." But there was no further communication. Not until I became aware of something in bed with me that night. The yelling of my name had stopped, but now something else started to happen. I awoke during the middle of the night only to see the ghost girl in bed with me. I saw her smiling face briefly. She was probably in bed with me every night. I jumped up and couldn't fall asleep again. I was being stalked by a ghost. Then I started dreaming of the dead girl almost every night. She would wake me up outside my body and tell me, "You are asleep outside your body." The dead girl would start singing me love songs. She would cry and laugh at the same time. One late night I heard the ghost say, "Wow. I am in love with you." I responded, saying, "But you are dead." The dead girl cried very loud and yelled out, "It isn't. It isn't. I am not dead." I wrote a book on my ghostly encounter. You can read it free online or buy at only $3. The link is provided below.